Hi, I'm George, and I'll show you how you can put custom paintings inside of your Minecraft world like I have back there behind me. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and subscribe as well. And when you click on subscribe, also click on that bell icon a couple of times to get notifications of my new videos. I'm putting up Minecraft videos all the time, and take a look at my channel for a bunch more Minecraft stuff. All right, let's get to it. I changed out a couple of the paintings that come inside of Minecraft with my own pictures. These are ones that I did as projects for my Photoshop Elements people. And it's pretty easy to do, to put your own work, and you can get much nicer results this way as compared to kind of the real fuzzy, hard to see pictures that come with Minecraft. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how this is done. Okay, here we are in my folder where I'm making this. Now I just made a special folder named Paintings on my hard drive here. You can call it anything you want. All you just need is a new folder to work in. In here, I have a couple of pictures. There's a picture of that girl with kind of messy hair. And here's that pop art picture that I did. I also have my pack.png file. This is just a simple 256 by 256 PNG. Any picture you want, that's all that is. And of course, the pack.mc meta file, which you have to have when you're making a resource pack. Now inside here, make sure if you're working in Minecraft 1.15.2, the current version, that the pack format is 5, right there. That's the important part. Down here it says description. This can be anything that you want. I just called mine painting. Okay, so I have that all set up and ready to go. We then need to set up our folder structure for the paintings. Now the right location for these, you'll need to have an assets folder. And inside of that assets folder is a Minecraft folder. Inside of that is a textures folder. And inside of that is where we'll place those paintings. Now to get those paintings, we need to go to the regular resource pack, and I have mine right here. There's my jar file. I'll put a link on how to get all this stuff in the description if you don't know how to do this already, so that's in the description. I've covered that in several videos, so I'll just pass on that on this one. Okay, so get your jar file downloaded, open that one up, go into the assets folder, into Minecraft, into textures down here, and then you want this folder right here, painting. I'm just going to right click and copy. Go back over here to my new folder structure, right click, and we'll paste this one right here. There we go. Now inside of this are all the paintings that come inside of Minecraft. You see there are some small ones in here, some big ones, some medium ones, some long ones. We'll change this one right here, and we'll also change that one right there. We'll use those two. Now when you're making this, what you're doing is you're going to be covering the existing picture with your own picture, and then saving that out as a resource pack and loading it in. It's really that easy to do. But there are a couple things that make it even better. Okay, I don't need this any longer. Get rid of that. And I'll bring up my favorite program for doing this kind of work, and that's Photoshop Elements. You can use any graphics editor you want. It doesn't matter. I just like to use Photoshop Elements for this. It's fairly inexpensive, and it is feature-rich, and you can do all kinds of great stuff in here as well. Also, both of the pictures I'll be showing you that I'll be using in here were both created inside of Photoshop Elements. All right, here we are inside of Photoshop Elements, and let's go ahead and open up those two files. I've already navigated to that folder just to save some time here, but I want that file right there, the bust.png and the donkeykong.png. I'll just hold the control key down, select both of those, choose open, and we'll get both these files open. Now notice in here something about the images that are used inside of Minecraft. They're really kind of messed up like this, real pixelated, not a lot of detail. It just fits in with the game, kind of sits in the background, don't really look at it. But I like these things looking a lot better. So the first thing we need to do is to increase the detail we have available for us inside of these. I'll just double the resolution on both of these pictures. We'll start with this front one right here. I'll go up to Image, come down to Resize and Image Size. And in here this has a width of 64 and a height of 48. If I double this one up here, these are linked together, the bottom will automatically change to fit. So double this is 128. So I just doubled the resolution on that, and then choose OK. Makes it a much bigger file as you can see here, but that's fine. Let's just get this out of the way. We'll come back to that in a minute. Here's the other one. I'll do the exact same thing here. Image, come down to Resize and Image Size. Now any good graphics editor, you can do, you know, this kind of a trick, this kind of a technique. Simply increase the size of your image. I'll just double this. This will be 64 by 64. There it is. And choose OK. All right, that's the first part. I'm just going to dock that one right there, and let's go to our zoom tool and fit on screen. There we go. I'll now open up my other two pictures. So File, and Open. I'll just back up here. There's my paintings folder right here, and there are those two pictures I'll be using. Getting a control key to select both, choose Open, and there we go. For the square one, I'll use this picture right here, and we'll save that one for the next picture. So here's my square picture. This is the one I want, and I'll be putting it inside of here. Any way that you can bring this into that file is fine. Again, it depends on your graphics program on how you do that. There's a neat trick here inside of Photoshop Elements, and that's the Place command. So here's the file. I'll go up here to File, come down to Place, and I'll grab that one, choose Place. And it comes in kind of at a weird resolution like that. Don't worry about that. I'm going to resize this up. That's just a temporary look. There it is. Choose OK. And then it refigures that or reconfigures that to match that size. You see down here, it looks pretty good. And then if I zoom this out to actual size 101, there it is. And you can see it has a nice amount of detail in there. At the size, we'll be seeing it inside of the game. And that's really all there is to it. Let's go ahead and I'll save this, and I'll be saving this twice. So File, Save. Because I have layers in here, it's going to save this as the Photoshop format, PSD format. I'm putting it into the right folder. There's my Assets, Minecraft, Textures, Painting. Save it in this location. That way I can come back and change this in the future if I want to. I'm all set up for that. Now the nice thing about Minecraft is it ignores any files it doesn't know about. It doesn't know what a PSD file is, so it ignores it. So I can have a whole bunch of my Photoshop files inside of that folder, and Minecraft just ignores those files. Okay, we now need to save this out or export this as the PNG file format, which is what we need to use in the game. In most cases, most programs, it's going to be either a save as or an export function. I'll use save as, and here we go, that's my location. I'll just save this out as a PNG file, which is right here. And I'll be saving it on top of that one. That's the name I want right there. Choose Save. Replace it. Choose Yes. And there we go. It's now saved as that PNG file format. Okay, let's get rid of that one. That one's done. Don't need that any longer. We'll be using this picture for their larger size image. I can just close that for a second. Here we go. Let's just zoom this to fit on screen. There it is. And then again, I'll use the Place command. Other programs have different commands. This just works out well inside of Elements. Place. And let's go back up here. There's my picture. And that brings it in sized to fit properly. Now it's a bit too small as you can see, so I'll just drag the corner out and we'll make this actually fit properly. And I'll do a better centering on that. Looks like that's pretty good right there. Choose OK, and then there's the final resolution on that. Now she's coming in just a little bit soft, so I want to sharpen this picture up. And in Photoshop Elements, that's Enhance. Come down to Adjust Sharpness. And here we go. You can see there's the before, there's the after with that sharpening filter applied to it. And that's fine. It looks good. Choose OK. Same thing. I'll now save this one out. File Save. I'll first save it as that PSD file format. Choose Save the Photoshop format. And now let's save it out as the PNG file format. Save As. Again, some programs this might be Export. PNG. I'm putting it on top of the Donkey Kong picture right there. Choose Save. Choose OK. And there we go. Those are now saved correctly into our new paintings folder. Okay, I'll just close this down. We'll go back to our folder and we'll then convert that into a resource pack. Okay, here's our working folder. There's the new pictures, that one right here and that one. And there are the Photoshop files, the PSD files that go along with those. Again, Minecraft just ignores those files, so I can leave those in this folder location. Let's now back up to my regular paintings folder. So I need to now take my assets folder, this is our new assets folder, and the pack.mcmeta and the pack.png, and zip those together. So I'll select this one, hold the control key down, and then choose those two files. Right click, and I use 7-Zip for this. You can use any zip program you want, it doesn't matter. As long as it saves to the zip format. That's the most important part. Okay, add to archive right here. Now in this program, it automatically grabs the name of the folder that these are in. That folder happens to be paintings. That's correct. Notice it says zip up there and my archive format is zip, and that's also correct. So we're all set to go. Choose okay, let that zip that up, and there it is. There's our new resource pack right there. Okay, I'm now going to launch Minecraft and we'll then bring this over into Minecraft. Okay, here's Minecraft and we're at the title screen for that. So let's click on Options and click on Resource Packs right here in an Open Resource Pack folder right there. And there we go. Now here's the old one that we had in the game that I showed you previously. I'm just going to delete that one, get rid of that. All right, and then here's our new one that we just made. So I'll take this and just drag it over into here. There we go, there's our new file. Okay, that's all taken care of. Get that out of the way, and that out of the way. Click on Done. Go back into Resource Packs again, and there's that new file right there. There's our new texture pack. Let's bring this over here. Now this only contains the paintings, nothing else. So I can just put it on top of everything else, and that works out just fine. The way Minecraft works is it reads the bottom pack first, reads the next one and overwrites anything in here that's in there, reads the next one and reads the next one. This one here just is my spacesuit that I wear. This one is the custom banners I have that are off in the background of that room that we're in. And this has just those paintings. This has all the paintings in the game, but it also includes those two new ones that we just changed. Okay, choose Done. It loads in that resource pack. And we can then launch into the game from here. Choose Done. Single player, here's my Minecraft world right there. We'll launch into this. I'll maximize the screen as soon as we're launched into the game here. And then we'll place those onto the wall. I took those off of the wall so we can have a nice clean wall to work with. There it is, nice clean wall. Okay, let's just maximize our screen. And there we go. Let's first put the big one on this wall here. So I'll walk over here. There we go. And I'll use the painting tool right there. And just right click and it puts a painting. Now you may need to do this a few times to get the right one that you want in here. There we go. So there's that one painting. If I get rid of this, it will tend to cycle through the painting. See, there's the other one that's real large like that. Right click, left click to get rid of it. So it cycles through and it's kind of random. But if you go through a few times, you'll get your new painting and there it is. Okay, let's place the other one up on top. And I had that one right in here. So we're still on our painting tool. Okay, it's giving me these long ones in here, so I want to block that. So I'll just grab a block and I'll put the block right there. And let's go back to our painting tool. It now gives me those square ones. And one of those is the one that we just did. There it is, and then remove the block. And that's all there is to it. Simply a matter of replacing the painting with your own painting, your own picture, and then bringing that in as a resource pack. Again, the thing that I like to do with these, I'd like to increase the resolution, just double the resolution. It still fits the game. It still feels fine. It's not too sharp, too crisp. If it's too much, it begins to look kind of funky for the game. But if you're just double the resolution, it works out just fine. It actually blends in very well to the game. So there you go. That's how you can put your own custom pictures and your own custom paintings inside of Minecraft. If you like this video, don't forget to click on that like button. Make sure you click on share as well, and also click on that subscribe if you haven't already done so. When you subscribe, hit that bell icon for notifications of my new videos. I do Minecraft videos all the time, and take a look at my channel for a bunch more Minecraft stuff. All right, and I'll see you next time.